The White House facing a lot of heat from several state governors of late who do not want to host thousands of immigrant children coming from Central America.
As John Riddell tells us, the immigration crisis is also dividing Maryland's members of Congress. John.
Well, Jennifer, members of Congress I spoke with today say they are very frustrated with the growing problem, and they say the issue must be addressed immediately. It was on the Fed's shortlist for temporarily housing immigrant children, this former Army Reserve Center in Westminster. But after public outcry, the idea was quickly rejected. So was another possible site in Baltimore City. But as the Department of Health and Human Services searches for states willing to house those children, members of Congress square off about who is to blame for the festering problem.
The president is not enforcing the border. We're having 10,000 children a month crossing that border. And now the president, instead of having expedited hearings and repatriating them back to their families, he wants to send them all around the country, including to Maryland.
But Congressman Dutch Ruppersberger says the time for placing blame has passed. He says the U.S. must reach a consensus on a humane way to deal with immigrant children.
They are here illegally. They need to be detained. But we have to do it in a humane way. We have to make sure that these kids go back, you know, to their countries, and then we can work through issues to have legality as it relates to immigration.
But Senator Ben Cardin says you can't simply turn away young immigrant children from Central America at the U.S. border.
First of all, you got to make sure that they're safe. Secondly, if they've been victimized, we need to know that and provide services. That's an international responsibility.
Well, they ought to have expedited hearings, which the law requires if they're underage and they're from Guatemala or Honduras, and then they should be sent back home.
Well, Andy Harris says the $3.7 billion that the president is requesting for immigration reform won't begin to resolve the problem. John Riddell, Fox 45 News.
Thank you very much, John. Children as young as 8.